thank you for the gift of this day and for all the gifts you pour out upon us. We thank you that you have called us to be people of faith, that you have given us a place in the body of Christ and a share in the ministry of Jesus. We thank you for the gifts of food and drink that you give us. And we ask and thank you for the work that you give us to do in Catholic Charities, reaching out to our brothers and sisters. For we know that as often as we do whatever we do for them, we do that for you. And may we always be aware of your presence around us, especially in the faces of those in need and those who are suffering. And may we always be generous stewards of your gifts, so that we may share with others in the same measure that you have given to us. We thank you for the gifts of food and drink that you give us in this moment to share together in this morning day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pour forth your blessing upon these archangel pins, and grant that whoever shall wear them may wear them with gratitude according to your law and will, and may they receive from you all the strength they need to be signs and instruments of your peace and your strength to others. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A while back, Ben Lyman with the Catholic Charities asked me what it is about the archangels that is fun and exciting, and why would you join? My answer is pretty simple, that it's a group of men who like to roll up their sleeves when they're doing community service work and have a good time. And they roll down their sleeves and be on a social hour to discuss our future projects. I like to say we try to get 10 wins a year, and some of our accomplishments in 2016, we bagged and supported Christmas distribution in Santa Clara. We had a social happy hour at Trinity Hall to raise awareness and financial support for Santa Clara and for our newest project this year, which is Our Lady of Perpetual Help. We did a community service project at Our Lady of Perpetual Help, cleanup, landscaping, painting, and carpentry. Some of our board members are involved with continuation of financial education program, and I think we're exploring some legal things as well. We assist in the Jesuit Texas Hold'em Tournament, which benefits summer camps for children in Santa Clara. We have an ongoing newsletter, which goes out to all Archangel members. And as I mentioned, the sponsored campers at Santa Clara, we raise money for that. This is our fifth annual Breakfast with the Bishop. We enjoy this day or breakfast as much as any of the days we have during the year. It's an opportunity for new people to see what the Archangels are about, and certainly the invitation goes out to all to join the Archangels. One of the things that's been a tradition has been that we have an Archangel of the Year, and I can assure you that all of our board members put in almost the same amount of work as the next one, but there's always somebody that stands out. In our first year, Steve Cook stood out and won the Archangel of the Year, and I'd like to call Steve to the podium to honor this year's recipient.
Thank you. Thank you, Kevin. As Kevin said, the Archangel started 6-7 years ago. I think the Catholic Charities asked a couple of men to organize and minister. Not a fundraising entity, but wanted to organize men so that they could get together, like Kevin said, and do some community service, roll up our sleeves when needed. We did a lot of work out at Santa Clara years ago, and this year we moved on to Our Lady of Perpetual Health. But also, if Catholic Charities needed some men to bartend at an event, or also do a breakfast, so it's kind of a men's group that's on call whenever needed by the Catholic community. And so I believe everyone who's here can be a member, because it doesn't cost anything. It's just sign up, be available if needed, whenever needed. So about 6-7 years ago, two men, Chris Shornack and Joe Hogan, were asked to organize this group and get it going. So it started with two people 7 years ago, and I can attest for the last 6 years, every meeting, every community service project, anytime the call was made that they needed some men to help out, Joe Hogan always answered the call. And so this year's Archangel of the Year goes to Joe Hogan, who has been very active and given a lot of time and effort for the Catholic community as well as the Archangels. Joe Hogan.
Other ways to expand actually being the hub site for their bigger initiatives of distribution to our diocese area. We're looking at dental, medical, and mental health services as a potential. Prison transition as an opportunity. Other opportunities will continue to grow. And then on the facility side, we really have some interesting things going on as well. We have a thrift store, I think you know, out in East Dallas that we're paying rent on, and I'll get to this in a minute. We have an opportunity to now consolidate and get out of that space and out of that rent and turn that $60,000 a year back into programming for the help of those in need. Interestingly enough, we have the same opportunity in this partnership with North Texas Food Bank to do that with the San Felipe facility, which I know many of you in this room helped to get going when they came together. And now we're going to try and save some of that stuff and move it to a new location in that partnership, become much more efficient, and in that process save another probably $50,000 or $60,000 a year in that. So all these things are helping us to be more effective in our impact. Looking at Marilac, the potential reopening, even if it's one day a week or one meal a week for the seniors. And our biggest news today, I guess, to announce is that we have found a new home for our headquarters. And we've been able to work with local banks and our board to land on a site on a mockingbird in between 35 and Erie Heights. It's the old Freeman headquarters, if you know it. And we've closed on the due diligence period, and now we'll hopefully close on the building at the end of November. It's 56,000 square feet, two stories, and a super new opportunity for all the Archangels in this room to help us to paint and fix up and land and make the space our own. But really, it's going to be transformational for us. It's in a better spot, much closer to where those in need are, much closer to the center of Dallas, very accessible to freeways. Mockingbird is probably one of the best known street addresses you could have in Dallas as far as recognizability and people finding us. So we're really looking forward to that. We'll do those innovations again, hopefully with your help and contributions we'll be putting together. This is an opportunity as a way of things we need and distributing that to you and beyond. And hopefully you'll be able to come back to us with some encouraging words of, yes, I can pay for a new compressor for the roof or whatever it may be. But we'll be looking for that help. But also on the volunteers on the site, truly there are some things that we use, some pretty easy products that really help to make that facility a wonderful facility. And with that, that is 40% more space than we have today. So that's where our consolidation opportunities are happening. It's also where our expansion opportunities are happening. We really do have an interesting time ahead of us now with so much need, so much poverty in Dallas, and growing every day, that with this additional space and with this consolidation of our efforts, we'll be able to really now serve those new missions much, much better. So we're looking to your help and advice on what those missions should be, where we can be most impactful, and how we can help the community the most. Other things coming up on the horizon is Catholic Charities Sunday weekend, if you will, the 12th and 13th, so please help us. We're going to have banner ups and posters in all the parishes. So as you go to each of your parishes and you see a poster, it happens to be kind of turned to the corner, so please reorient it for us and help us to make sure that we get the word out and communicate with everyone that this is the time, the one time of year, that we go to the entire diocese and ask for your help for all the parishioners. We have arguably around 700,000 or 800,000 people attending Mass each day. If we could just get $1 from everybody that came to Mass, it would make an incredible difference on our effort. So hopefully you can help us to talk it up, spread the word, and help people realize that this is a super opportunity. And every $1 matters. $10 even better, and every $1 matters. Hopefully you can help us do that. And then of course, on January 28th, we have the gala. A few of you listen to the news, the Bishop's Gala. We're very, very excited about that. We've already got the undergraduate committee together, headed by Steve and Benny Solentrop. They're chairs for this year. They're doing a wonderful job, and we have a lot of people coming together. We're hoping each of you will think about joining the effort, getting tickets, hopefully buying a table, maybe getting together and getting a gold or platinum level table as a group. We'd love to have that type of support. Again, those type of things are really transformational to us, because the hardest thing for us to do in charities is to generate programming dollars. Things that really make a difference, but they're also kind of the black hole dollars, because you need them every year, time and time again. And that's the hard dollar to get you. That's the hard place to help the senior, or help the person who really is on the edge of poverty, that we can help bring out through our coaching and financial stability services. So I talked a little bit about that and bringing your help to the table. And the other thing is just to help us to procure more donated goods, whether it's for the new building, the new opportunities there, or just in general. Again, working with Mike and his group on how can we do donated and thrift goods together better than we've ever done it apart, and seeing how we can really expand that effort with our trucks and our donation boxes and their thrift store. How can we really marry those ideas together? We have more work to do on that. There's just so many creative thoughts that we're working on as a team at Catholic Charities and with others in our community. I was. We're so thankful for your help and advice, wisdom, treasure, and prayers. We're blessed to have your support and collaboration in welcoming the stranger, serving those in need. I'm here to tell you, I think the state of Catholic Charities is strong, growing, and ready to do more. And we're thankful for your time and for your help. We again appreciate your time. God bless.
Things are so important. It's kind of bringing all that together. So I'm just very excited about the work that you're doing, very grateful for that, and just very grateful to be with you here this morning. So thank you.
What I'd like to do is remind everyone that we just went through this, that we have several events that we're involved with. The Catholic Charities Sunday, which is November the 12th and the 13th, which is held in all the parishes, and it's that second collection. Please remember the things that you heard here today about the good works that Catholic Charities does. We have the Angels, the ladies, also an organization and sister to us, actually is that's their one of their focus projects. But we do assist. This is where you collect all of the Christmas. I think every parish may have a giving tree where they you pull an ornament off and it will have the name of a child or gift that they would like, something like parachutes, and those gifts are all collected, and they are assembled by family, because they're assigned to specific families, but there is someone that needs to, some organization that needs to collect all that, organize it, and distribute it. Well, on the December 12th through the 16th is where the distribution assembly takes place, and then the distribution itself takes place on December the 17th, which is a Saturday morning. And that is, that's where hundreds and hundreds of cars will line up on Jefferson Boulevard outside of Santa Clara, drive in and pick up their packages, their Christmas gifts, if you will, which have already been reassembled for them and for their family. This is something that the Archangels typically help with. We would need people and men to show up and to help with the distribution process. And then, of course, the Bishop's Gala on January the 28th, which is the most significant event for the Catholic Charities. And then in the spring, date undetermined yet, we'll have a cleanup day where we'll work at Our Lady of Perpetual Help on a Saturday. Basically, it's a little roll up your sleeves events. And come in for 2, 4, 5, 6 hours, whatever you can do. And then we will have our last sort of event of the season. It is a good group of men, and it's good people to be associated with. Now, with that, I just noticed that our featured speaker has arrived.
Speaking of battles, imagine for a minute that you're a defensive end or a linebacker for the Dallas Cowboys, and you're fighting in the trenches with the San Francisco 49ers, or at least in one case, vice versa. And imagine that every Sunday for 11 seasons, and in this one case, helping your team to 10 wins or more a year. What a battle that would be. It's an honor for me to introduce to you a man who I've come to know, who is a father, a good son, a friend, a neighbor, and despite radio ads to the contrary, is also a home builder. I can't forget to mention that this mild-mannered man is also a 5-time Super Bowl winner, and there's no debate about this man as an NFL Hall of Famer. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to introduce Charles Lee.
Guys, it's an honor to be here. Thank you, guys. It's, it is my son went to Jesuit, and I think it changed his life, and he changed mine because the slogan meant for others. I didn't understand what that meant because it was about Charles, and when he came home with that, that helped me realize that, you know, I need to push past being an individual and really impact other people's lives. And one of the things we did was we formed Tap Tomorrow. It's an entity that we use to take education down to the inner city schools. During the summer, we did 10 schools this year. It's helping you guys is one thing. Do it because God sent you. It's not about you having money, having resources, because kids don't need that. They need love. They need to know somebody cares a damn about them, you know? And God, it affects high school, college, and the NFL. And, you know, I started college and work up when I'm dealing with players because, and I'm very, very hard on parents because you know your kid. You want to make excuses for your kid, but you know your kid. I go probably to 5 families' houses or 10 probably a month to talk to that kid about being bipolar. Soon as I walk in, soon as I sat down, soon as I open my mouth, the parents start answering every question that I ask. They do not let their son or daughter take responsibility for their actions. So it's hard to reach. And guys, you are even harder because you know what? We as men, we'd rather run out of gas than to start an accident. And that's one of the big things that I had to deal with. Because every time that I turn around, somebody does something dumb, they have a mental illness. The moment that happens, thousands of men go back into I piss off a lot of guys because, you know, I talk real. You know, when minorities comes into the NFL, they never had nothing, so they want everything right now. And I tell the parents, they want it all right now. The cars, the women, the jewelry, whatever, the big house, they want it all right now. They're not forward thinking. And that's because, you know, nobody's told them. Well, I can only speak for me because nobody told me that I had an opportunity to go to college. Nobody told me that you know, that I could fulfill my dreams, my ambitions, my hopes. Nobody told me. My mom was firm. The only thing she did, she managed to get an education. You know, 3 of my brothers turned down scholarships because they were afraid that they wouldn't make it. I went to reading writing lab. The lady told me that I'm doing it at a 10th grade level. I grabbed my paper and I ran out, guys, and I started crying as I was running. And I said, okay, now what you gonna do? I said, if you wanna stay here, then you need our help. So I walked back in, and I think I might have been still crying, but you know, I told her that a net got in my eye. So, but I asked her for help, and she said, the one thing I can promise you, I'll give you all the help that I can, but I won't do your work for you. And I kissed her on the forehead because the one thing that I learned from her is that education is the key. No one can take that away from you. No one. And so I just try to instill that in my kid and in other kids. You know, I'm proud of my kids. They overcome a lot of issues. Especially when they deal with me, because you know, my kids grew up afraid of me because they didn't understand the bipolar man. You know, they would be telling jokes at dinners, would be at a 5-star restaurant, and they would say something. I would hit the table hard. You know, the 3 tables beside them would get up and leave, and my kids would look at me. life is, that is about choices. And you know, we all as Christians, we talk about faith. You know, for me, faith is action. And you can't just sit there and say, God, give me $1 million. No, you gotta step up. All he wants you to do is take one step. So guys, take one step and help somebody else. Hey, take one step and help somebody else. Me, I go to Starbucks and stand there and open doors for people. It was raining and I'm at a grocery store. I go buy an umbrella and then walk up to the thing. I do something every day to let people know that I care, and I tell them pass it forward. You know, you got men that want to stand up for something, or refuse to go down in the hood. You know, hey, I go down there, I know what it is. I'm not afraid, because I grew up like that. But if you're going to make a stance, then you got to bring everybody with you. Not only just the black guy, but you got to bring white players with you. And the only way you do that, guys, is you got to love one another. I was fortunate enough to play with teammates, guys, that no matter what happens, we love each other. You know, hey, racism in the locker room. But you know what? You know how you beat that down? Be a good teammate. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what people think about you. It's what you think about yourself. You know, only success comes is through hard work. And someone got to lead. And they always said, somebody got to lead, somebody got to follow. I'd rather anybody lead you with me. Winning the Super Bowls, guys, was because I had 11 guys, I had 53 guys standing with me. You know, crying with me, straining, you know, you got coaches. And it's about team and that's something that they don't understand anymore. It's not about how many sacks I get in a game. It's, do we win? Play with everything we have. I learned a game of football, man. Bill Walsh, God, man, he was really a good man. I've never been around anybody like that. It's like most of my life. Every time I get around somebody that I truly love, they always leave. You know, 2 years, win the Super Bowl. And then everything sparked up. I love Jimmy Johnson, man. He was a tough-nosed guy, man. But he out of the youngest team, we went back to back. Jimmy had stayed probably 1-4, you know, or more. Cowboys had the most talent I ever been around in my life. There would never be that much talent. You know what I do, guys? I always take it with me, and I always have to leave it in my jacket, right? And when I put that jacket back on, I see it, and then I'm going, oh my God, why didn't I do that? Then I send a check in, you know? So, guys, if you don't feel like today, put it in that jacket, you know, and take it home or put it in that pants pocket. And then remember, when you pull it out, put some in and send it back, okay? You got some baby powder for that?
So I ask you to bow your head, please. In the name of the Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather as men of faith. We thank you for the gift of your Son to show us the way that we should live our lives. We thank you for the gift of mercy during this year of mercy that you have shown each and every one of us in the trials and tribulations of our lives. We thank you for calling us to be good stewards of the many gifts that you have given to us. And so as we go forth today, we ask for your continued blessings upon us. We ask you to send out your blessings on Catholic Charities and all of their staff and their volunteers who continue the work of your Son on earth. We ask your blessings on the Archangels Network that give us guidance to show us the ways that we can better build your kingdom. And we hope that all of our efforts with your blessings will continue to build your kingdom and lead to your greater glory. We ask that you would open our eyes to your presence among us, in the poor, the hungry, the homeless, and in those who look like they have plenty, but who have a hole in their hearts because they need you. We ask that you bless us so that we may serve your people, because in serving them, we serve you. And we ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.